has some room. In there for the touchdown. Coming home here in lane five. Well out in front of the field. And Malachek touches in a time of 52.92, a new high school national record. Back to back to back to back state champions. Nebraska Public Media Sports, your home for championship sports, is live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, Nebraska for the 50th anniversary of the NSAA Volleyball Championships. Our fourth matchup of the day as we get set to crown our fourth champion is in Class C1 as the Lincoln Lutheran Warriors take on the Kearney Catholic Stars. And welcome back inside the Bob Devaney Sports Center, everyone. Along with Kathy Wieskamp, I'm Larry Putney. Good to have you with us. And Kathy, this is a rematch of two teams that we're going to see very high-level volleyball.
High-level volleyball. Both have experience here at the state championship in the finals. Lincoln Lutheran, they've been in the finals three out of the last 4 years. They've won every tournament they've been in this season. They would love nothing more than to capture this tournament championship trophy as well. Now, Kearney Catholic on the other side has also had experience, and they had Lincoln Lutheran on the ropes in a tournament this year. Let that get away. They would like to, again, avenge that loss and come out with a state championship trophy in their hands as well.
Yeah, between these two teams, 70 total wins, six losses. Lincoln Lutheran, obviously, right here in the capital city. Kearney Catholic just down the road in Kearney. And the Stars got here with wins over Pearson Lakeview. Lincoln Lutheran with a couple of sweeps over Bishop Newman and an impressive win over Sharon Zavala's GICC squad. Let's go down to the floor to the third member of our crew. Here's Ryan Mix.
Well, Kathy mentioned it. Lincoln Lutheran and Kearney Catholic played in a heck of a match earlier this year in the district final. And Lincoln Lutheran also beat Kearney Catholic last year at state. And I can guarantee you Kearney Catholic has that on their minds heading into this match. They don't like to use the word revenge amongst the whole team, but it's certainly been a motivating factor for them, and they'll get another shot at the Warriors this afternoon. And Lincoln Lutheran, they're coming into this match really confident. They've beaten every Class C opponent they've played this year. Their only losses were to Class B opponents, Norris and Waverly. So should be high level, great volleyball, and another competitive match here at the state championships.
Yeah, should be a good one. We are celebrating 5 decades of NSAA volleyball championships and all of the associated programs. We have the Class C1 championship coming up next.
All this grass, all this mulch, all these projects to do, they all get done with the Kubota BX Series tractor. The Kubota BX Series. Kubota is a proud sponsor of Nebraska High School Sports on Nebraska Public Media. It's the crack of dawn, but it's never too early to get ready for hunting season. Acceleration, handling, and cargo room for work. The Kubota Sidekick. For more information and participating Nebraska Kubota dealers, KubotaNESports.com.
Opportunities. They're found here, and here, and here. They inspire her, motivate him, prepare them. And when those opportunities start here, they can take you anywhere. Wayne State College, where opportunities today prepare you to lead tomorrow. Explore WayneStateCollege.com.
This is a growing corn plant. It's not battery powered. It doesn't have a 300-mile range, but it's vital in our fight against climate change. Reducing 46% of carbon emissions and producing clean-burning ethanol. Corn ethanol is the climate solution we need now.
Sometimes you just have to be a little stronger, go a little farther, be a little tougher. This past year was a test to see if we could step up and weather the storm together. we are committed to push a little harder, go a little farther, lean into the challenge, and be tougher together. Aurora and you.
From just outside the Bob Devaney Sports Center here in the capital city, state championship volleyball. Class C1 title is on the line between Lincoln Lutheran and Kearney Catholic. And now for introductions, let's go down to Steve Lemon.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center for Championship Saturday of the 2021 Nebraska School Activities Association State Volleyball Championships. Today's Class C1 State Championship match features the third-seeded Lincoln Lutheran Warriors and the number one seed, Kearney Catholic Stars. The NSAA is proud to recognize our premier corporate partners for their outstanding support of NSAA activities. U.S. Bank. U.S. Bank, Farmers Mutual Nebraska, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association, Lincoln Orthopedic Center, and Nebraska Orthopedic and Sports Medicine. And now it's time to meet the teams. First up, let's meet the Lincoln Lutheran Warriors. Number one, Carrie Limbach. Number two, Reagan Hawley. Number three, Alicia Sadoff. Number four, Lily Pensick. Number five, Adriana Rodenzel. Number seven, Ashlyn DeBoer. Number eight, Jordan Ernstmeyer. Number nine, Addison Blahovitz. Number 10, Sophie Wolgamuth. Number 11, Molly Martin. Number 13, Erica Young. Number 16, Caitlin Oxley. Number 20, Shanae Burt. And number 24, Abby Wackel. The assistant coaches are Kelly Riley, Michaela Higgins, Michelle Suits, and Kelly McGrew. The head coach for the Warriors is Sue Ziegler. And now let's meet the Kearney Catholic Stars. Number one, Lauren Kenteris. Number two, Margaret Harburg. Number three, Ashley Keck. Number four, Jenna Cruzy. Number five, Sophie Connor. Number six, Josie Denny. Number seven, Claire Rogers. Number nine, Avery Mandernack. Number 11, Lindsay Vanderbeek. Number 12, Malia Johnson. Number 14, Peyton DeZingle. Number 15, Sydney Connor. Number 18, Callie Squires. And number 19, London Carnes. The assistant coaches are Robbie Yoakum, Mackenzie Smith, and Amy Johnson. The head coach of the Stars is Chris Connor. Our officials are Jen Myers and Kim Kwapnowski. The bench official is Tanya Mulder. And now, let's play state championship volleyball.
Ready here in Class C1 between the top-seeded Kearney Catholic Stars and the third-seed Lincoln Lutheran Warriors. Let's look at the tournament resume for these two teams. As we said earlier, between the two, 70 total victories on the year. Lincoln Lutheran's 12th trip to the tournament. They've won it twice, last time in 19. They've been in this championship now three times in the last 4 years. Kearney Catholic, it's been a while, but boy, they had that run in the mid 2010s where they were in six consecutive finals. They won four straight from 2012 to 2015 under the direction of Chris Connor, who is in her 30th year. There is Sue Ziegler of Lincoln Lutheran in her 24th year for the Warriors. And there is Chris Connor, 30th season on the bench for the Kearney Catholic Stars. Should be a good one. They faced once already this year. You heard Ryan Mix off the top talk about the first time they met in a tournament this year. They met in round robin play. Kearney Catholic won set number one. Kearney Catholic led in the second set, Kathy, 24-20. And somehow the Warriors came back and found a way to win it in 3-2-1.
And again, that's the fight in these two teams, as you've mentioned. They have battled, and they're two great programs that have a lot of respect for each other, too. So it's going to be a good matchup. It's going to be great level, high level of play. Looking forward to it.
Into the block, and right there is Caitlin Oxley. Serving is the freshman, Carrie Limbach. Great serve by Limbach, a little tight, and another point for the Warriors. Good start here for Lincoln Lutheran. Well, that's a tough serve just over the tape. Leads to a free ball. Explodes on the tandem run, Abby Wackel.
You know, that quick tempo, that's what you got to have. That it beats that block. They pull her inside and in the gap between the two blocks, and she fires it through.
Wackel has had 14 and 12 kills in the first two matches down here. They'll do it again, this time run the middle. But good job to stay home by Mandernack, and Mandernack gets the block.
Blocks, like you said, staying home, taking that angle shot away. Good setup.
Tried the angle, high hands, and got it. There's Ashley Keck, and you're going to see a lot of swings from Ashley Keck.
A lot of swings and a lot of kills. She averages 16, almost 16 and a half kills per set. Again, lots of swings at the ball, but her efficiency is the point part that stands out to me.
Bump set, rolled over and found the back, and there's Wackel again with two swings, two kills.
Just great control of the ball, knows the open area of the court. She doesn't swing through that, but again, uses that wrist to control it, and that wide open space in the middle back.
On the overpass, put down by Caitlin Oxley. Oxley's had 9 kills and 6 kills in back-to-back matches.
Again, tough serve here by Lily Pensick. Set that up, and Oxley finished it.
What a smart play. They went to Wackel in the near corner, and Wackel sent it right back deep corner for the kill.
Just a great decision again, watching the defense, knowing where those open areas are. Defense sits in the middle, so those deep corners, lots of real estate.
Seven-two here early on. Warriors with their first service error of the match. 7 kills already to go along with 7 points. Very efficient hitting right now for Lincoln Lutheran, hitting 571. On the slide, powerful swing once again by Caitlin Oxley.
Oxley coming around on that slide, does a great job. Almost got past that ball a little bit, knowing where she is in regards to the court, takes it back, and gets the kill.
Wackel now back to serve. Off the side of the block of the kill by Ashley Keck. 2 swings, 2 kills for Keck.
kick, tooling it off the block. Ball was a little bit inside. Use those hands.
Long on the serve. So each team with a service error early on. Didn't clear the net by Harbert.
Would have been a good opportunity. The middle block of Lutheran wasn't there to close, but the set a little bit low and into the net with that swing.
Chris Connor will take an early timeout here in set number one, her team trailing 10-4. Let's flash back to last year's C1 title match.
The 2020 Class C1 State Championship was a showdown of top-ranked, undefeated teams as the Wahoo Warriors faced the St. Paul Wildcats. It was a back-and-forth battle with St. Paul 1 point away from taking an early two-set advantage until a 4-0 run gave Wahoo a second-set victory. Both teams traded wins again to push the match to a fifth set. After going down 10-6, Wahoo's Maya Larson led the Warrior comeback and secured Wahoo's third championship in 4 years.
Here we are 1 year later, the 2021, back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center after being at the Pinnacle Bank Arena last year due to COVID protocol and the unavailability of the Bob Devaney Sports Center and kind of how the schedule ended up working out. Back to serve for the Warriors. Sophie Wolgemuth, sophomore outside hitter for the Warriors. Out of the timeout, they'll run the slide. Good coverage off of the block touch. Free ball opportunity. Joust at the net, and it's won by Shanae Burt. Shanae Burt with the kill.
Just great discipline by the Lutheran blockers, getting back in their base, being focused, watching that ball, and going up strong, being ready.
Strong block here early on for the Warriors. Set it up again. Pushed out, rolled over by Burt, not down. DeBoer with the swing.
Great.
Up alive.
Action.
Wow, that's a nice swing out of the back row, and they will find Ashley Keck in many places out of the back row, just one.
Yep, wherever she is. You better keep an eye on her, because you can guarantee the setter knows where she's at. Net, but a, yeah, but a great swing there by Ashlyn DeBoer on that right side. She does a great job. She's kind of got a dual role. She both sets and hits for this Warrior squad.
Brushed across, but a good up there by Cruzy. Nice up by Keck off of the swing from Sadoff. Right back to Sadoff to go again. Keck is there one more time. Keck out of the back. Linebach with the up there. Long rally here early in set one. Big point for Kearney Catholic.
Those are so important to win, those long rallies. A lot of energy comes off of coming out on top in those situations. Sydney Connor finishing it up.
Connor, a 5'11 setter, committed to Washburn in Topeka, Kansas. Coach's kid, so you know, high volleyball IQ. And there is another kill by Keck.
They just keep coming.
blocked by Keck.
Yeah, she's just does great things out there on the court.
Aggressive swing on the outside. Shanae Burt with her second. Back to serve for the Warriors. Nice tool by Wackel off the block. Wackel's perfect. Four kills, four swings.
Can't beat that. Again, she's just strong in her moves, her action. She's confident, goes up and makes a strong decision.
That time Wackel got tooled from that right pin off the swing of
Harburg.
Harburg. Thank you, the hair was in the way.
I know, it's hard. It's known, Harburg again, being aggressive up there, working that line shot.
Keck got down. She'll get another chance here. Don't push it over. Bump set out to Wackel.
Wow.
Wow, 5 for 5. How about Wackel?
Can't ask for more. Goes up, two big blockers right there. But look at that, wrist down, slices it through. The block didn't get it, and the defense can't recover.
It seemed like a setup there. That was out of system, bailout to the left pin, and Wackel still found a way to terminate. Josie Denny now back to serve. Senior libero for the Stars. Pinsick now serving for Lincoln Lutheran.
Great pursuit, great up by Limbach, and again, no quit attitude. Great up. Underneath.
That's a point for Kearney Catholic.
Limbach just again, like a little scatterbug on the floor. She's so quick, her feet are so good. She's getting a lot of looks already from some D1 schools. Just a freshman starter for this Lutheran team.
First hitting error for Abby Wackel.
Good turn there on the ball. Again, Oxley blocker in front of her, recognizes, and then turns and takes it back to the right side of the court.
Tooled the block there on the slide.
Squires on that right side there. She's actually a middle. They rotate her out on that serve receive. Have her swing away on that right side. And did a great job.
Not a good set out to the left pin. Not down by Harbour. And then it does not clear the tape. And since that early open by the Warriors, Kearney Catholic has settled in, down by just 4.
Just kind of getting in the groove here.
Look at the numbers for Keck. She's had back-to-back matches. 22 kills and 31 kills for Keck.
Not bad.
Whoa. But Great hustle there by Squires along the front, out of the back row kick. Goes right back at Squires off of her and out. Kill by Ashlyn DeBoer.
And just a nice job there also by Lily Pensick to change it, change directions, work the backside pin, keeping the blockers moving and off balance.
Two contact. Back to serve goes Callie Squires.
Didn't get it to clear there.
Four touches. Shot deep corner, good pace set up by Mandernack.
Mandernack again got in there, that quick tempo, doesn't give the block much time, but even at that, she works around the block and finds that deep corner.
Great second touch. Ashlyn DeBoer.
Just a great job again. You're going to see it pinched in here. And just again, that good read, just far enough out of reach. Couldn't get there. Just knowing what the defense that your opponent's in really gives that setter that advantage and knows what those spaces are on the floor.
Harburg with an aggressive swing, but good dig.
Connor, good job to stay out of the net there.
Boy. Right down the line goes Wackel. Six kills.
Impressive swing there by Wackel. Down the line. They give her not a lot of room, but she definitely threads that through there. With some authority as well.
Into the antenna goes Wackel. So out, point for the Stars. Warriors just four away here in set number one. Harburg back to serve. Tip is down.
That's what kick does. She sets you up with the power swings, and then she comes back with, again, a finesse shot. Really, again, reading and just good control. I mean, she just laid that over the top of the fingers and down the backs of the blockers.
Line back now to serve. Line back opened it up with that impressive run for Lincoln Lutheran. Good run in the middle. Mandernack again.
Mandernack really reading the situation well. I also like that she's in there. She's pushing the tempo, and Connor's feeding her up too. Connor's just good at connection and getting her the ball where she needs it.
Wackel got it. Just kind of push it over.
Again, when you're in those situations, just knowing what defense the opposing team's in allows you to, again, make smart shots, and that's exactly what she does. Oh.
Keck right on the line, and another kill for Ashley Keck.
Here they bring her inside. We've been seeing her swing from the outside. Here they bring her in. They kind of cross her into that middle section. Gives her a little different look, and she delivers. Good block, but good coverage as well. Again, that corner, that deep corner has been profitable.
What a great shot.
It's a great shot, but a great pace on the ball, too. Again, I think the tempos, not only locations, but a lot of times when you change that tempo, really makes a difference.
So timeout taken by the Stars here near the end of set number one. Warriors looking just 1 point away from a set win. Let's look at Wackel.
Wackel's doing a lot of positive things. You see her from the inside, pushing the outside. And again, she has hit some line shots that kind of catch your attention. Let me tell you, she really is doing a tremendous job, knows what the defense is that she's working against, and then trying to capitalize on that and find those open spaces.
8 kills, 6 digs, 1 set. That's not bad. Hitting 385 for Wackel. There's Sue Ziegler, head coach of Lincoln Lutheran, her 24th season. Set point here for the Warriors. Sent over by Connor.
Connor really, again, not ready for this one to be done yet. Stepping up there and taking charge herself.
Set point number 2. And the ace.
Keck.
Ashley Keck, 70 aces on the year to lead the team. 7-0.
I was going to say, did you get that right? 70. Incredible. Tough server. Really getting in. We talked about her all-around play. What a great player she is. And does so many things for this team. Not only is, again, her physical play, but her leadership. She's a 4-year starter and, again, one of those players that her teammates look to.
I want to remind you, coming up here in set number 2 of this Class C1 state title, John Peterson, former Columbus SCOTUS head coach, will be joining us. Here's who we've had already. Linda Carlson was here. Sue Mailot, Karen Stoner. And yet to come, Diana Rose and Rochelle Rolfs. Interesting catch up with Coach Peterson. I understand he's picked up golf.
Mm-hmm.
Retires and picks up golf. I think I want to beat John Peterson.
Another point.
Kearney Catholic making a late run here, trying to do to Lincoln Lutheran what Lincoln Lutheran did to Kearney Catholic earlier this year. Came back from 24-20 down. There's another hitting error, and all of a sudden, they're just one away from sending this to extra points. And the dangerous serve of Ashley Keck continues. Good pass. Got it. When they needed it, they went to the middle. Caitlin Oxley, and Oxley delivered, and the Warriors take set number 1, 25-23. So Lincoln Lutheran here in this C1 state championship have a 1-set-to-none lead. Oxley closes it out for the Warriors.
Constellation is a natural gas supplier helping inspire young Nebraskans through hands-on learning. Constellation has given more than $290,000 to 4-H and FFA organizations across the state, helping support youth in your community with opportunities to achieve real-world success. Because we believe that powering communities means empowering our future leaders. With Constellation, a contribution to 4-H and FFA is in the stars.
Have you heard about FAFSA?
It's like a form you fill out.
Fill it out and you get money for college.
Easiest way to get money for college, hands down.
FAFSA.
It's a life hack.
It's your way in.
So you want to help me pay for college? I'm down.
Heck yeah.
Definitely.
How is this not trending on all the things?
It took me like 30 minutes to fill out.
So easy.
How much am I gonna get?
This is a hidden gem.
Fill out your FAFSA.
FAFSA.
Drink water, buckle up, fill out your FAFSA.
We're for agriculture, for growers, doers, whatever it takers. We're for doing things with purpose. We're for the little guy with big guy dreams. We're for agriculture. We're for you. Nutrien Ag Solutions. It's thanks to you that we're where we are today. We're proud to watch these communities grow because they're our communities too. Our neighbors, our friends, it's where we live. These are all our hometowns. And no matter what, the people who will continue to serve your needs with the hometown support you know and trust are just down the street. Cornerstone Bank, growing together.
We're back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center here in Lincoln. Lincoln Lutheran takes set number one. Valiant effort late by Kearney Catholic, but 25-23. And Lincoln Lutheran on top, one zip. We are pleased to be joined now. We've been talking all day long with pioneers in the state of Nebraska in volleyball, and there is no one who had more success during his tenure than my good friend John Peterson. Great to have you with us.
Oh, thank you, Larry. It's great to be here.
15 state championships. You finished 8 years ago. Does it seem like it's been 8 years?
No, you know, it's just hard to believe that it could go that fast. I mean, and I, you know, there's a lot of parts of it I miss, some of it not, but yeah. Kathy probably can agree with that. But it's been a great time, and I've enjoyed the 8 years too. I've had a lot of fun.
I bet it's these moments you miss.
Oh, I do. It's just the thrill of being down there on that bench. Mm-hmm. It just there's nothing like it. There's nothing better than that.
You see the resume: 863 career wins, 15 state championships. Seven runner-up, that means you were in the title game 22 times in your career. When you look back and you think, why were we able to be so successful, what do you point to, what do you credit it to, outside of great players?
Pure luck, I guess. I don't know. They couldn't have been the coaching. Well, you know, mentioned the players, but also, you know, I had a great coaching staff that I worked with, and, you know, that coaching staff stayed together for over 25 years. I mean, that's from 7th grade to 8th grade, the freshman, the JV coach, Janet Tooley, and great people to work with and lots of fun. We had so much fun.
Well, talk about, again, you getting into volleyball and how you got connected to volleyball and how you kept trying to, I guess, hone in on the craft of being a great coach.
You know, that my first year of teaching, I was at Newcastle, Nebraska, and one of the other newcomers, they said, you two will be our officials this year. So, you know,
other
that was
duties
back
as assigned?
Well, and I was up on a step ladder, you know, you could have got killed if somebody ran into it. But, you know, it was, so we did that. And the next year they asked me if I wanted to be the head volleyball coach. And I said, yeah, I'll do that. That would be fun. And, you know, and then obviously back then there wasn't social media or all the, you know, you couldn't Google everything.
Right.
So it was more about reading in books. And one of the best things I did was I came to a clinic down here, and it was a club coach, and I just can't remember what his name was, but he went through every fundamental and all the progressions to teach everything. And that was enlightening. I mean, it was amazing. And I was fortunate when I was at Newcastle, I had some really good kids that worked hard. You know, we had the old hard rubber balls that were, after practice, their arms were just, forearms would just be beat red. And, you know, and then it's just a matter of learning and learning and learning and going to clinic after clinic after clinic. And, you know, I know you mentioned Coach Pettit. You know, I went to his camp for clinic for about, there's his camp, I worked his camp probably 10 or 12 times. And you know, that was really, I mean, that gave you a lot of insights that you don't get otherwise.
3-2 here in set number two. Of course, the Warriors took the first. They're on top 1-0, jumped out to the 3-0 lead. Kearney Catholic with the serve here. Jenna Cruzy on the serve. Talk about, you know, the level of play that, you know, not just late in your career, but what we've seen even over the last 10 years in terms of the specialization and how high of a level that these kids are playing at now.
Well, it's, you know, the level is obviously keeps growing every year. And, you know, it seems, and also the size of the players, it seems like, you know, that's a factor. But, you know, the liberos, with the advent of using the libero, the ball doesn't, you know, they just make so many defensive plays. You know, and that's a kind of neat thing. If you're watching like Nebraska, Wisconsin game the other day, oh my goodness, the defensive plays on both sides, it's incredible. And in high school, they see that, and the coaches are teaching so many great fundamentals, and that's what's amazing is how it has changed. You know, you just wonder how can it keep it evolving even more and more. But you know, the play, the swings, the setting has gotten better and better, and just all around plays, and it's fun to watch.
Used to be if you had the tall girl in your team, she probably was a little slow and not athletic, and now you get 6'5", 6'6", and they can fly across the net. And just so athletic.
I know. How come I never had a 6'4", 6'5"? I just never had a chance. I have. I mean, one year we, in 1996, we had a great team, and I think we finished all class number one that year. I mean, I'm very subjective, obviously, but we had a 6'3", and a 6'1", and 5'11", 5'10", and we thought we were a college team walking in. Now that's kind of normal for a lot of teams.
Yeah, no kidding. Big block there by Harburg on the left pin. And the Stars, who were down 3-0 to start, now on a 6-2 run to take the lead.
And Keck really playing a key role in that again. She's back here from that service line. We know her up at the net, but she has done some tremendous stuff keeping the serve receive and controlling what Lutheran has been able to do with that tough serve.
Caitlin Oxley with the kill there. So update us, what are you doing now, John?
Well, you know, after I retired for 8 years ago, I went up to Wayne State and helped up there. A good friend of mine, Scott Kneifel. He called me like that summer and said, you need to come up. I said, Scott, I just retired. And he said, come up whenever you can. It's about an hour 20 drive to go up there. So I was up there part-time for 6 years. I did that.
Oh, wow.
And then COVID hit last year, and I said, maybe this is time to be done. But I enjoyed it, thoroughly enjoyed it. It was, you know, another level. That Division II in the conference we're in is amazing. Mm-hmm. And he just recruits great kids that just are wonderful to be around. And so I got to do that. And it gave me a chance. Obviously, I play lots of golf now, so I have like four or five friends that are retired coaches and teachers in Columbus, and we play golf about every morning.
So I heard you picked up golf. Had you played much before?
No, you know, you did once in a while. We didn't know what you're doing because I play five or six times, you know.
And probably
summer.
Didn't have time because you were coaching and doing everything else.
You know, I painted houses in the summer.
Yep, I knew that.
And then we had open gyms. I was coaching volleyball, basketball. So that was four nights a week. And then with camps and everything, you just didn't have a chance to play.
So is it true you have five hole-in-ones? Or holes in
ones?
I did. So in 2018, I got two about 6 weeks apart. And this year, I got three, each of about 2 months apart. I got 2 weeks ago, I got my third one this summer. That's crazy.
Oh, my God.
I'm not even that good, but I guess I'm really lucky.
Wow. So, you know, we're here today, and we were talking about the Black Court, Terry Pettit Court. Tell us about the court at Columbus Scotus. It's got a new name, I hear.
Yeah, that's pretty humbling. It's kind of funny, the AD, a year ago this summer, he says, we're going to redo the floor. We're thinking about putting a new floor in or totally refinishing it. And they end up just totally refinishing it. And he says, he said, well, can I come over and talk to you? And I thought, oh, boy, what's he want?
And paint something or do something?
So, well, what does he want me to teach or coach? I didn't know. But so I said, yeah, come on over. And he came over and he says, I want to get your permission before we do this. We want to name the court after you. You're a part of the 20 state championships that are on there for volleyball and basketball. And he said, we really want to honor you before you die. That's what he said. And then we laughed. I mean, he was being very facetious, but and how do you say no? I mean, it was, I said, yeah, I guess, but it's super humbling and it's pretty neat. just hard to believe that there's a guy could, that would happen. So it was a great deal.
Well, again, yeah. we always talk again. We've always loved state tournaments, and we've been working for years and stuff. But I always think it's old home week because we always have the opportunity to get to see you and visit with you after the match and good things that are happening. So it's kind of like we have a reunion with you. But talk about, again, 22 final appearances, 15 state titles. Is there any of them that really stand out? I know they're all special and all that, but anything that, you know, the year just turned different and it came out to be such a positive ending?
They're all super special. Mm-hmm. You know, if you said one, I would never want to say one team is better than the other, but two that were really probably surprising in a way that in, I think it was 2004, we had like 115 match win streak.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And we played Lincoln Lutheran in the final. And we'd beaten earlier in the year twice, but very, very close. And they got us in five. And we returned our right side starting and our libero. And they had at least four of their starters back and really good players. And so that year, we just got better and better. We split with them during the year, and then we end up beating them in four at Pershing to win it. And, you know, I just think there's no way that's going to happen. So that was pretty special. And then probably the other one that was really special was we were played Grand Ole Central Catholic. We played them a lot of times in the finals.
They were heavily favored, yeah.
And they were 35-0. They'd beaten us three times.
Mm-hmm.
The first time we just got clobbered. It was at their place. And, you know, it's like, oh, I even remember one of their scorekeepers, or he was keeping the book. He came up to me after the game and said, oh, don't worry, you'll be there when it counts. You guys always get better and better. And I said, I thought that guy's been drinking something. I don't know what he's been doing. So we did get better. The second time we played him in the conference tournament, and it was closer. The third time, they beat us in the district final. But fortunately, there was a wild card at that time. So we got in on the wild card, and then we played them in the final.
Yep.
And it was a great match. I mean, it was 15-12, I think, in the fifth. And
it was
shocking, but it was a great win for us.
13-10 here in set number two. It was 10-10, so a 3-0 run here for Lincoln Lutheran. Yeah, if you watch any broadcast, sports broadcast on Nebraska Public Media, that call of you winning the state championship, SCOTUS pulls the upset, is at the beginning of every broadcast. It truly was one of the most remarkable battles back and forth and unexpected outcomes.
Well, it was, you know, and then our fans, or I don't know, the kids or whatever, they put in the, you know, at the Coliseum, they put a banner up, and it had GICC, and it said Grand Island Championship canceled. I can remember that like nothing, you know, and I thought, boy, you better take that down. We don't want them to even see that, because they don't need any fuel.
Yeah, since you said that, we should probably apologize to other C1 coaches around the state, probably having PTSD seeing John Peterson right now on the broadcast thinking, please tell me he's not back.
No, he's not back. He's too old.
So a little insight into this one. I mean, clearly two very talented teams. You've watched a little, I'm sure, down here. Talk about level of play and what you see between, you know, Kearney Catholic and Lincoln Lutheran.
You know, I had not seen Lincoln Lutheran until yesterday. I came down to watch the semis, and I watched both of those teams, several matches on TV on Thursday, mm-hmm. or Wednesday, I guess it was. And so I got to watch them, and, you know, after the first two sets, and I'd seen Kearney Catholic during the year. I watched them play against SCOTUS and watched them play against Lakeview. I thought after the first two sets, I think, there's no way. And they came back and got better and better, and Lakeview struggled a little bit the next three sets, so they came back and won. And I think they're playing pretty well here today.
Yep.
And then as the first time I'd seen Lutheran, I hadn't seen them live. And, you know, they just have nice overall size. They're very athletic. You know, I'm still helping with basketball at SCOTUS, and we played them last year. And, you know, I think they're in the state tournament. I can't remember whether they finished third or runner-up or what they were last year, but they just have some really nice athletes right now. And Sue obviously does a great job. And so I think, you know, I knew Kearney Catholic was going to have to really play well. And again, you know, the coaches there do a great job as well. And so I, So I think they're playing pretty well. They're playing pretty tough, and Keck is really, she's on dynamic. Fire. She's a great player.
Mm-hmm. Dynamic. Off the block and out of the kill by Shanae Burt. Burt averages nearly 10 kills per match, and there is a look at Sue Ziegler. Oh, did they? Did it go off the antenna, perhaps?
Yeah, I think so.
But you see, Coach Ziegler wanted clarification too.
Yep.
Looked like it went off the block.
We'll see.
And out here
if we
again.
Can see again.
Yep. Might have missed it.
So we've seen some great defensive plays. You know, a lot of big swings. Keck herself is just again a power swinger on the outside, but. I think the level of defensive play that we've seen, you mentioned it before. What other things have you see, again, that has really evolved over the time?
Well, you mentioned defense. I think the setting has gotten better, too. You know, there's a lot of really solid setters. And the variances of attacks, you know, even in the last 20 years. I think back, I missed that 96 team that we had that size. But we didn't run near the stuff that they're running now. I mean, we should have. I'd love to coach that same team again with the size that we had. You could just do so many more things. And so I think that's really something. And again, the defense is incredible, so much better. And the block, you know, the advent of swing blocking. Mm-hmm. I don't know, Kathy, when you played, did you swing block?
Nope.
And I didn't 8 years ago when I was in, we didn't weren't swing blocking. I fiddled with it a little bit before that, and I probably didn't give it enough of a chance. But about everybody's swing blocking now, and so that's a different type of thing too.
Just the pace, you know, we've talked about that. The tempo of play is so much faster, and the athleticism. You know, we talked about that. Did you run a strength program or any of those things to try and help again, because too preventive of injuries and so forth?
Well, we were big in the weight room. And that's one of the things I was really fortunate with. Our kids, we really stressed a couple things. In the classroom, we wanted to academically be really good because, you know, I think the better you are in the classroom, the better you're going to be on the court. So academics are really big. And then the weight room was something that we really stressed, in the summer, and we lifted all during the season, both volleyball and basketball. And, you know, we wanted to be a very, very strong team. And, you know, I was fortunate I had a lot of girls just work their tail off in the weight room so we could increase our vertical jumps. You know, we were testing a variety of different things, and certainly vertical jump was one of them. And, you know.
Wackel again, 13 kills for Abby Wackel.
Got a big arm, big swing.
Yeah.
So I mean, the weight room is huge to do that type of thing. You got to be strong to be really good. And you know, I had some years I just go, wow. I had one of the girls that played for me, a girl by the name of Christy Korth, was about 5'4", 5'5", and she ended up playing soccer in college. And I mean, she could bench press 160, 165 pounds,
wow.
Which is kind of crazy. And almost everybody in the team was the same way. They'd be benching, and I know benching isn't the whole deal.
Yeah.
But between 125 and 165 pounds, it was just, you know, that's, and you just are more confident that you can do things.
There you see Wackel, who's hitting 429 here in the match, 13 kills, 21 swings, just 4 errors. Keck with 8 kills to lead Kearney Catholic. And it seems like every time the Stars start to climb back in, they had it even at 14, the Warriors have managed to go on a run. They've rattled off 3 in a row here to take a 17-14 lead.
Well, and with big swings like that by Wackel, I mean, it really energizes, and again, just confidence just keeps exuding from that, and again, can frustrate the opponent.
Served by Holly, and an ace. Reagan Holly makes it a 4-0 run, her 32nd ace of the year.
That's what she comes in, that back row defensive specialist comes in, provides that tough serve as well as great defensive play.
I think serving's got tougher too.
Yes, it has.
Right?
I mean, it certainly has. I mean, everybody serves tougher. You know, almost everybody jump float. There's a couple of people jump top, but you don't see that very much anymore. But everybody, because that's a big part of the game. You got to try and get them out of the system.
Well, and that slight variety in the type of serve also keeps their receive off balance.
Into the block. And now 5-0, 19-14. Stars out of timeouts. Just a little tight on the set. Mm-hmm. Two touches. The double touch called to the Stars, and now it's 20-14. Warriors threatening to go up 2-0 here in the C1 title game.
They just don't have many weaknesses, do they?
Yeah, it's a very well-rounded, I mean, you look at what they did yesterday to Savala's team, that was impressive.
Mm-hmm.
They just seemed out of sorts the entire match. It was,
well, they have so many weapons. I mean, they really spread their offense around. The setters do a great job, and not everybody has that luxury of having that many weapons.
Mm-hmm. Well, and then they run that 6-2, so they keep, again, making sure that they have some strong attackers in every position.
Wackle again.
Talk about strong attackers. She is on fire right now, and that block is it's not even getting close. It's not touching the ball. She's threading it right between them.
How about the set from DeBoer, though? I mean, that pass was at her waist, and she bump sets it right on spot to give Walker a clean look.
Taking a ball and making something better out of it and giving it to the next person in a better situation.
Weinbach with a great dig. She's going to be a good one. Two touches called on the Warriors. Still four away here in set number two.
Weinbach's just a ninth grader, too.
She is already getting D1 looks.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Wow.
Just again, she's just fast feet, has great instincts on reading and where she's at.
Yeah, John, it's Ohio State, Texas, Nebraska, Creighton. Those are the schools that are already looking at her.
Oh, wow.
So it's high level college looks as a freshman.
That's really high level.
Mm-hmm.
Well, she has what Nebraska has been looking for recently in liberos, which is low center of gravity, small, and able to move very quickly in the back row. You look at their last three liberos, they've just been really mobile, but also low center of gravity.
You know, years ago, I remember going to a Nebraska, I think a Hawaii game, and Hawaii was, they had, what, three little girls back there that just passed lights out, dig everything, you know, and that's what Nebraska has right now. I mean, they just...
Right.
Yep.
They're three defensive players. Yes, three of them.
I call them the littles. You know, we've got the littles in the back row, but you just can't get the ball down.
No.
Littles are pretty big.
Yep. Playing big.
They play big.
Yep.
Second touch not down. From that left pin, Harburg gave it a go. Long rally here. Wackel keeping it alive.
Free ball.
Opportunity here for the Warriors. Wackel too tight.
Set kind of in between the two attackers.
Thought maybe she was had a middle there.
Yep.
So once again, a little run here for the Stars to make it 21-18. So John, 50 years of celebrating Nebraska High School Volleyball Championships and the way it's grown, and just want to say thank you for stopping by and chatting with us. You've certainly been a big part of that. You must take some, I would guess, a great deal of satisfaction in your role in helping the sport grow here in the state.
Well, yeah, I mean, volleyball has been great for me, too. I mean, I would never have thought that the success that we've had would ever happen. I mean, when you first start out, you just want to win some games. And then you want to, then you, in 1982, the first year we went to state, and we got beat in the first round, and we were ahead in the third set big, and we lost, you know, and then it kind of snowballs from that. And, you know, and so the volleyball has been great for me, and it's been great for our school and the kids that play. Just, I love them to death about all the time and effort they put into, and I just love to talk to them and visit with them again. And you know, that's what you kind of miss. You kind of miss that camaraderie that you got.
Yeah, I thought you were going to say you just hope to go out and win a few games, and then suddenly you do, and there are expectations.
Well, you know, but you right? set a standard, a you culture. Yep. You developed a confident culture that this is what we do here.
Yep.
Yeah, there's, I mean, tradition is huge. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you can get it going, then, you know, the little kids, they come to camp, they want to be, mm-hmm. they want to play down here. Mm-hmm. They want to have a chance to do the same type of thing. And, you know, you can't say enough about it if you can get it going. And it's not easy. There's so many good teams today that you just have to really work hard at it.
Success certainly breeds success. Two programs on the floor here that are proof of that.
Yes, I mean, Kearney Catholic's had some great success, and now Lincoln and Lutheran as well.
Just off the net, rolled over. Quick run in the middle of the kill by Mandernack.
Stars just keep coming at them and being aggressive. They're playing strong, not tentative at all.
Each of the first two, they've come back late to mm-hmm. make it close. Can they close it out? That becomes the question. Good opportunity here on the free ball. Bump set off the net. Wackel tries deep corner. And then Keck powers through the block.
Kearney Catholic has just kept fighting. Yep. They're not giving up at all. I mean, that's what they did yesterday, too, to win.
Mm-hmm.
They just never quit. You could have easily quit after first two sets against Lakeview, but they didn't.
And then the big block on that left side. Harburg's got it, and we're even at 22. And Sue Ziegler's going to take a timeout. Something to be said about a team that knows how to not buckle under the pressure, right?
Well, absolutely. You know, Kearney Catholic through the years have played in a lot of big matches. I mean, down here, you know, in the state tournament. And Lutheran has too, so they're both, you know, they both understand pressure. And, you know, both of those two teams are in the same conference with SCOTUS and the Centennial Conference, which is just brutal. I mean, there's so many good teams. Lincoln Christian's in there, Davis City Aquinas. Yeah. Hastings St. Vincent's under Alan Bancura had great success. And, you know, they're just, that really gets you ready to play in matches like this.
Well, before we let you go, first want to say thank you. I want to show you one last picture before you take off. There it is, the John Peterson Court. And one or two trophies there around you. How about that?
It's almost sick that could. I mean,
every other coach that played against you saying the same thing right now.
I know.
It's almost sick.
It is. It's like, how could that ever happen? But you know, what a great run. What a great fun. Yeah. I mean, that's the thing too. You know, I talk about my coaching staff, but we just had so much fun. Mm-hmm. I know it's probably everybody saying, well, yeah, it's fun when you win.
Yeah.
But we had, you know, after every tournament, we'd go out and we'd have pizza and do stuff, and we just had a great time. And that's what you miss. That's what you miss, that and the girls.
Yep.
Well, John, we want to say thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate your contribution to Nebraska volleyball, making it what it is today. Truly one of the pioneers in the state when it comes to high school volleyball. And I'm still waiting for my invitation to come out and play golf. So
okay.
Thanks very much.
Well, Larry, I appreciate it. And Kathy, you too. Both of you have done a great job. And I really appreciate that.
Thanks.
Thank you.
John, thanks
love
for joining us.
You bet.
That is John Peterson, a longtime coach at Columbus SCOTUS, 15 state championships, 7 runner-up. He had that remarkable 115 consecutive match winning streak from 2001 all the way through 2004. We've got a great one here on the floor. Don't want to ignore that. It's 24-23, Warriors within one of taking the set and going up 2-0. So back to serve for the Warriors. Wolkemuth, tough serve, and the ace! Sophie Wolkemuth with the ace on set point. And Lincoln Lutheran takes the second, 25-23. Same score that they won in set one. They lead it 2-0.
Are you ready? Let's go. 4 years of high school can prepare your girls for who they'll be the rest of their life. That's why it's important for students at Marion to have every opportunity to develop in the arts, the sciences, all academics, as confident, faith-filled leaders in their community and beyond. The journey begins here. Marion High School. Discover what lies ahead.
All right, it's time to talk about us. Not him, not her, not them. Us. Thanks to us, things have been great. In fact, you can find us just about everywhere. Your food, that's us. Your food's food, that's us too. Your fuel, that's us. And should anyone out there happen to doubt us, by all means, just watch us.
Electricity. It makes life easier, more productive, brighter, possible. Yet we only think about it when we don't have it. The next time you're doing, well, anything, think about how electricity makes it all possible. And know we will be there, powering your every day, every day.
After concussion, returning to the classroom is a priority of the NSAA. All brains return to learn, not all brains return to play.
After recognizing that an athlete has suffered a concussion, it is important to monitor the symptoms in the classroom before allowing the athlete to return to extracurricular activities.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course once every 3 years.
More information is available on our website, nsaahome.org. Student athletes are students first, athletes second.
The balanced attack of the Lincoln Lutheran Warriors has given them a 2-0 lead here in the C1 title match. That young lady right there has been dynamic. Abby Wackel, 14 kills, 29 swings, hitting .276, two digs away from a double-double.
And again, she has been doing it with, again, authority out there. I mean, she has been ripping the ball. She's taken it to different locations. She's taken it hard between the blockers. She's taken that line shot and truly executed incredibly high this afternoon.
Keck, meanwhile, one kill away from a double-double. She has 9 and 15 with the ace. Keck has been fantastic down here at State. Mm-hmm. Back-to-back matches, 22 kills, 31 kills. Sydney Connor's done a great job of distributing.
You know, Keck, talk about Keck again. She broke a record for kills in a match, kills in a season, and career kills. I mean, she is one, talking about a program and a school that has had outstanding players. She really has done a tremendous job.
There's Carrie Leinbach, the freshman libero.
15 digs in today's match. Just, again, one of those players that just quick with her feet, reads well, and a great addition as a ninth grader coming to this team. She's also been tough at the service line as she walks back there now to go serve too. She's really been effective there, started this whole match and kind of set the tone from the beginning.
Great dig.
Yep.
Right on spot. Mm.
Well, and the thing about not only is their positioning, she's very relaxed with that upper body and then can absorb and take those big hard hits and keep them in play and on her side. Look at that, great up.
Just out of the touch by Wackel. Tried to keep it in, 1-1 here in set three.
And we just talk about Leinbach too, that effort, that consistent, just laying it all out there. DeBoer just not being able to get her feet squared and get turned so she can get a clean set. Just trying to push that.
Served by Jenna Cruzy. The other way, one-on-one, tip try not down. Like the decision by DeBoer. Walk-up.
Well, and they don't push her to the pin. They bring her to the inside, and then that gives her full steam to come driving in, and she slices it inside that block, and just the explosive and the power that she is producing. I'm loving watching her play.
Ashley Keck with another one. She's committed to Concordia, four-year starter on this team. All-state record for kills in a match, a season, a career. One of the best to play for the Stars. +1,500. Over 60 kills now down here at State, and she's got a double-double.
I think that in itself speaks volumes. Playing against the best.
There are the school records. 36 kills in a match. 626 on the year. 1536 for a season. All updated, all current, all school records.
All impressive.
Byers now back to serve. Pitsit goes behind. DeBoer keeps it alive.
Great job there to keep that alive.
Pitsit got to the far pin off the top of the block, but not down. Deep corner try by Connor. Into the block, there is
Harburg
with the block.
She's done a great job blocking over there on that right side. That line, she has completely taken that away, sealed it up, and pushing it, forcing them to go cross court. Big block there.
Got it through and down, back quarter.
Pensick doing a great job distributing the ball, working pin to pin, utilizing her wide range of attackers, and ends up with success.
Sydney Connor makes it 7-4.
Good idea there, Molly Martin, just a little bit wide, that little soft touch there, just not quite soft enough.
Just a bit long. And just long. Five service errors on the Warriors, just two for the Stars. And the Stars also with three aces in the match. Aggressive take right off the hands, and Burt with another call, with another kill.
Burt, one of those seniors on this team. Again, a heavy senior-laden team for the Warriors.
Great play. Found the corner. Wackel with another kill. 16 for Wackel.
And it goes back to being smart out on the court, knowing your opponent, what defense, and where those areas are. If you're not in a perfect situation, where's the place that I can put it that makes it difficult for the opposing team? Kick right there. Easy feed right up to her. Back at that service corner again. She can get a string going. A tough floater. Just really the physicality there of that swing. Blockers there, knocks him off the net. And you've got to go up strong just because the power that's coming from that swing of Wackel.
Catch off the block. 12 kills for Ashley Keck. Now back to serve for the Kearney Catholic Stars, Jenna Cruzy. Double again. Seen a lot of that called here today.
Yep.
Point for Kearney Catholic. Swing wide.
Good tempo change, but great up by Keck. Top of that ball, nice feed right up to her, and quick tempo.
Time out of the floor, 13-11. Stars holding on to a two-point lead here in set number three. Let's go down courtside to Ryan Mix.
Hey guys, well, senior setter Sydney Connor for Kearney Catholic, the daughter of head coach Chris Connor, was in a really serious car accident just under 2 months ago on September 22nd. She was actually hit by a train in Kearney in town, and thankfully, obviously, she is okay. The car was completely totaled, but she did fracture her L2, or lower back vertebrae, and has been playing with a stiff back. She had to sit out a few weeks, and her first match back was against Lincoln Lutheran, and didn't come back 100%, played through a little bit of pain, and coach said she's doing her best to play through the pain. Since this is her senior year, she wants to do everything she can to go out a state champ. She'll be playing at Washburn in college, where her sister Shayla is an assistant coach. But obviously very thankful that Sydney is okay, but it was a really serious accident. The train was going about 40 miles an hour, and there wasn't a crossbar that came down, and it was in the morning, and Sydney said that she was just kind of blinded by the sunlight and had her music turned up too loud and didn't hear anything. So really scary moment, but thankfully she's okay and here playing volleyball.
Well, that's something that could have been really very tragic. And again, so glad that turned out the way it did, but incredible story.
You see her taped up and bandaged up. She's still in the process of recovering, but the fact that she's out here and able to compete in her senior year with teammates is, it's remarkable. Cool. Pushed across, not down by Wackel. Here is Keck. Boy, Keck was inside, had one choice. Fire that off the block.
Yep.
And it worked. Let's take a look at what Sydney Connor has done so far here this afternoon. Connor with a kill there.
Well, she's running this offense as, but she's an aggressive attacking setter. And so she makes strong plays, strong moves. Again, she knows where to take the ball. She's smart in her decision. Coach's kid, again, high IQ, and then has the ability out on the court to execute. Didn't get over the net there.
Back to serve now is Abby Wackel.
You know, this third set, nobody's really kind of taken charge, or it's just kind of been a back and forth, and strong play there by Oxley.
Oxley floated with that perfectly and gets the block.
But just again, a couple points here, a couple points there, nobody really stretching it. Great hand on the ball.
Yeah. Harburg with the kill. And just long. Even here at 16, set number 3 at the C1 title game. Loggemuth, who ended set number 2 with an ace, another tough serve, puts the Stars out of system. Opportunity for Lincoln Luther, didn't finish.
Great up. Gosh, great defensive play. One of my favorite, love the effort of players, again, pursuing balls, laying it all out.
Line violation called on the Warriors. So back to serve goes Connor. Off the tape of the ace. Connor, fourth ace for the Stars of the match, and a timeout taken by Lincoln Luther. They trail by 3, 19-16. Impressive match for the senior outside hitter for Kearney Catholic, Ashley Keck.
She's right now 13 kills and hitting a 132, 53 swings at the ball. And again, she just does so many things for this team. She's strong in her play. She's smart in her decision making. And again, one of those players that you just love having on your team, just because, again, she brings others around her up to that next level as well and comes through and delivers.
Yeah, it's been more than 50 years since the passage of Title IX, opening pathways for girls and women in sports, and it covers sports, admissions, academics, and more. Over the next year on Nebraska Public Media, we'll be telling the story centered around this monumental legislation. So this spring, the pioneers of women's athletics in Nebraska will join us to share their perspectives in a special called Title IX, 50 Years in the Making. Learn more and share your Title IX story at nebraskapublicmedia.org/Title IX. The 50th anniversary of these state championships. Pleased to be able to bring those to you here on Nebraska Public Media.
Well, and just again, the other thing about the tournament, how it's evolved, it's progressed, and the not only again the play, the coaches, the venues, the experience, all of that has just really continued to evolve, and just top-notch state championship.
Stars not going away. Your John Peterson mm-hmm. talk about it. Up by five here, and then a big block on the left side. Harburg again. And a timeout taken again by Sue Ziegler. Well, if you'd like a copy of these NSAA State Volleyball Championships, just call 1-800-868-1868 or visit nebraskapublicmedia.org. Just $19.95 plus shipping and handling, and you can relive all of the excitement from the 50th anniversary of the Volleyball Championships for years to come. This is our fourth of six title games today here on Nebraska Public Media. Falls City Sacred Heart won this morning in Class D2, followed by Howells Dodge and Oakland Craig in D1 and C2 respectively. Both of those schools winning first ever state titles. And another ace. Out of the timeout, they dial up an ace and they're two away.
One at a time, patience, perseverance. Erica Young coming in just to try and change things up on the Warrior side.
I'll go right to Erica Young.
Love that confident, aggressive swing.
And that is wide.
Pensick giving a big set slap of the hands of Erica Young, encouraging her as she comes in and makes an immediate impact.
Back to serve now, Ashlyn DeBoer. Bump set to Harbaugh. And that is long of the swing, no touch point for the Stars. And now Kearney Catholic, one away from taking set three. Harburg will serve. And the ace for Harburg. That closes out set number three. And all of a sudden, the Stars start dropping the aces. That is eight. Check that, five service errors for the Stars. That's a set winner. Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Three sets of the books here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center, and here are the two leaders for each team. Ashley Keck on the left, and on the right, Abby Wackel.
Wackel with 18 kills and Keck with 13. Both of them really have made a huge impact in the match so far. And we're not done yet. They're both on their way. You can see Abby Wackel with a double-double, hitting 268. Just again, so consistent on that outside. Ashley Keck as well on that outside.
Yeah.
I mean, another double-double there, 13. And talk about back row, defensive play, 22 digs. She's like a defensive specialist when she goes to that back row, doing some great things.
Underway here in set number four. Kearney Catholic hoping to even this. Two apiece. Right now the Warriors lead it 2-1. Quick run in the middle and the kill. That's Molly Martin.
Martin doing a great job, that quick tempo. And we've talked about if you can beat the block by going with speed and changing that up, you're definitely going to have an advantage and frustrate the opponent in the block.
That is down, and another kill for Keck.
I believe that was that Johnson coming in the middle? Or was Keck?
That is out. Wackel with another one. That is 19 now for Wackel. Wackel's had 14 and 12 in round one and two.
And the thing about that Lincoln Lutheran is doing, sometimes they pull her inside and sometimes they push her to the pin, and the blockers are trying to figure that out and stay with her.
There's an aggressive punch by Harburg.
You know, we talk about Keck on the outside, but Harburg also has been very dynamic out there, explosive, and really great compliment, the two of them in that outside position.
Lift called on the Warriors. Stars out to the quick 4-2 lead.
Callie Squires frustrated with herself there.
Wackel back to serve.
Net. Warriors pulling together again, just kind of getting recollected there. Great job by them. It looked like actually Carrie Leinbach was kind of rallying the troops as the freshman in there, trying to settle them down and focus them.
Good run in the middle there is Caitlin Oxley again. Oxley coming off 9 and 6 kill outings. She's headed to DePaul next year to play.
And that makes 11 for her in this match, and hitting 400, so pretty impressive numbers there.
Oh, nice
great
job to get a hand
on that ball.
Into the net. Violation on Lutheran.
Sophie Wagmuth did a tremendous job making this great defensive play, reaching out with that hand, popping it up, giving her team time to step in and make the next play. Tough serves, just really driving.
Lutheran here over the last one plus set have been a little high error, just some small mistakes that have giving Kearney Catholic advantage, and they're taking it.
And Kearney Catholic has been really driving this serve and, again, working those edges of the court and pulling them out of the system. So you can start adding all those things up. It's really, again, pushing or giving the advantage to the Stars.
Back to serve now, Ashlyn DeBoer. Good pass in system. Was mistimed with Keck.
Oh, great place.
Terrific placement. Molly Martin.
Just looking at the court again, those open areas, those corners, just and the players are having to chase out of bounds. And even if you get your hand on it, you got to really angle it to bring it back into the court. Crate up under. Her whole hand across. She did a great job there. That was Carrie Leinbach. But you can have partial, but fully over is a violation. Started out with, again, great defensive play there, just firing that arm underneath it, pancaking it up. Just couldn't finish.
Slow roller by Shanae Burt off of the hands and gets the kill.
Just good controlled swing, just smart there. Taking it to an area.
It just felt like maybe inevitably we're going to get to 2020, so we should just start them.
I know.
It's been very back and forth, little mini runs here and there.
Mm-hmm. There's a shot.
Walker again, evening it at 8.
You know, Walker, just a great shot. Kelly Squires wasn't able to get there, you can see. But like I said, a lot of credit goes to, again, her appearing at different places along the net, staying inside, then pushing all the way to the pin, just utilizing that whole third of the court. A lot of an area to cover for a blocker.
Nice job by Harburg after
staying with that.
Yep, going the wrong way, readjusted. Kept it alive. Left it in the middle. Martin knocked down, but a free ball. Time out a little further and just punched right into the donut.
Walco, just a great job there, changing it up. You've got a lot of, everybody's going up big. She's been having the power shot. High hand roller.
Right. First time out for either team here in set number 4. Another look at it.
Right in here, lots of open space. And she puts it right in the center of that whole area. Everybody collapsing, nobody retrieving.
It was right in the middle of the campfire. Kathy, you want to try that drawing again? If maybe we do that replay from the top angle again.
We call it the fire, and it was kind of a flame. I thought.
Is that what?
More,
got it.
Kind of.
You drew the flame.
She hit the very center of it. Did you notice that?
I did. I did notice she hit the center. I just thought it was the center of, like, a chip.
It what? Yep. That was an interesting donut.
It was a donut
triangle.
That looked like a chip. Yes.
Donut triangle.
Got it. It's a new thing. Back to serve for the Warriors, Reagan Holly. Aggressive swing by Keck, but not down. Walker gets a shot at it, and wow.
She can whack that ball, let me tell you. She comes in there, and like I said, the efficiency of it is both where she's hit attacking from various spots, but also then the speed. They really try to push that tempo. And she's beaten blockers, and that quick arm swing that she has, a lot of positives. Great hands on that
all
ball.
All over the place.
I know, and she just lays it out.
Ah, deep corner, what a shot.
Well, and Linebuck, who's deep in the defense, yep, had come up just for that. That ball had played up here, came up tight, that left that open corner. Great decision. Nice.
Wackle right down the line.
And I know I keep saying it, but she's reading her situation so well. The blockers, you can see, caught inside. Connor couldn't get out, which again slowed Squires.
Double touch. ...12-9 Lincoln Lutheran here in the fourth. Linebacker to serve into the net. Tough serve. Leads to the free ball here. Tried deep corner. Higher might have worked. What an angle.
And she didn't really get a situation where she could take that big approach, but she got her feet to the ball, her shoulders square, so she could really still make a strong play. And just again, that thumb down, that hard, sharp angle.
Good reaction to keep it alive. Good rally here.
Great job by Squires.
Wackle off the block and got it. 24 kills, now 25 for Abby Wackle.
And again, Lutheran doing a tremendous job just using a lot of attackers, spreading it around, and Squires is running pin to pin across the net, trying to keep up with the various attackers. Good push to the outside there by Pensick. Nice finish again by Wackle. Just keeps adding to her numbers. She's at 26 now, folks. Tooling and using.
5-point advantage here in set number four. Watch Linebach. Oh, yeah.
That's how it's done. She says, I'm here to back you up. You're doing a great job. She's a competitor.
They're into it.
That's why fans are here. They're here to keep the energy high, keep their team going. That extra player.
Well, let's take a look at the Warriors. Abby Wackle.
You know.
Hold that right inside the back line.
26 hitting 327. She's just reading her situation, making smart decisions.
That last one was a.
Yep. That's a. Just a impact kind of shot.
What's the sign say on the Lincoln Lutheran side? Whack-a-mole?
Kind of like whack-a-mole kind of thing.
There you go. Waka-waka.
Oh, here you can see the sign too. God bless Texas. Lily Pensick, transfer.
Ah, yeah.
Here from Houston, Texas. Senior coming in and making a great addition to this program. Her dad will be the new athletic director at Lincoln Northwest. And so really an opportunity leaving and coming here for a senior year and playing it for a state championship.
down to the swing from Wackel. Boom! That was pounded. Full swing by Harburg.
Harburg had a one-on-one situation, and she said, I can see a lot of court here, and just fires away.
Big swing there from Harburg. Einbach tried deep corner. They'll go back to Harburg again. What a shot. She readjusts and goes inside the antenna to go off block.
And Ashley Keck pops that ball back in and puts it right into that center court. Setter could set that up, but a great finish there by Harburg.
16-14, Warriors on top. Sue Ziegler will take a timeout. First timeout here in set number four for the Warriors. Stars are out of timeouts. Match led right now by Lincoln Lutheran. They're on top 2-1 and trying to close it out here in the fourth. Well, you know, Monday, November 15th, the Nebraska Public Media production of Beyond the Baton follows Thomas Wilkins, the longest serving music director of the Omaha Symphony Orchestra. Wilkins celebrates the end of his tenure as music director with a powerful concert, Beyond the Baton. It airs Monday, November 15th at 9 p.m. Central only on Nebraska Public Media. Wackel again, 27.
She just keeps coming, and again, great decisions to feed her. You've got a player that's just got the hot hand and can't be stopped. Setters, smart decisions to make sure they get the ball to that person. And Wackel is that person on the Warrior side.
Lift call and the set there. 17-15. Back to serve now goes Sydney Connor. Left it in the middle. Explosive swing. Caitlin Oxley again. Oxley's had a nice match.
Yeah, she has, and she's taken this one straight away. The block is struggling to know which direction she's going to take it, and she's doing a tremendous job reading where the block is taking and going away from it.
Yeah, Oxley with 12 kills, hitting 391. Mandernack in the middle on the other side with the kill for the Stars. Mandernack hitting 500. Seven wow. Kills on 14 swings. No errors for Mandernack. The Stars can get in system and feed her. She's had success. Good up by Linebaugh. Right inside the back line. Great swing and a kill.
And the Stars handled that ball that was sent over in control and really put him in a situation to feed up Keck on that outside. Same thing with Keck, pulled her in a little bit there, took a different shot, a swing there inside.
And then the ace by Harburg, even at 18.
Just that good roll.
Good hustle by Linebaugh. Double hit, double touch.
You know, we talked about Linebaugh and just her quick feet and just driving to that ball. And then the other part she does, she controls. She knows where she's at in relationship to that center line, keeps herself on the side of the net. Just great hustle.
10 minutes ago, I think we said we might as well just fast forward.
I was just thinking the same thing. Here we are. Oh, great.
What a kill by Peck. 2019 Stars.
And she takes those sharp angles, but the thing that she does, she keeps them in the court. She doesn't go long. She gets on top of the ball, puts that topspin, and it's just working the edges, and the defense is struggling in, out, getting there quick enough, all those things.
Nice play. Good, smart shot by Keck. And a timeout taken by the Warriors, 21-19. Good little shot to the deep corner.
You know, when you start looking at the defense, as they're sitting here, these corners really create some vulnerable areas. And not only is it open, but the defense, as you can see, has to go to the outside of the court. So they're flying out toward the edges. So if they get to the ball, they got to bring it back over top their shoulder. So it's just a good location. Great decision to be able to place it there and make that defender move.
Last time out of set number four for both teams. So they'll play the rest of this set without the benefit of a timeout. In the match, surprisingly, Kearney Catholic is out hitting Lincoln Lutheran 201 to 152. In this set, the Warriors,
both of them
hitting 419 to 417. Wow. Great play here in set number four.
And again, that's why we're not seeing these big gaps in the score, because again, kills, and they're answering with efficiencies.
Into the block.
That felt really good for Callie Squires. She's been working hard up at that front row. Lutheran has been challenging her, running her up and back along the net, but she is here, and she has shut the door on that one. Oh.
Ooh, nearly an ace, yeah. And then nearly a bump set kill. A bump kill. Brought back in by Waffle.
Great. Yep. Molly Martin, just great decision seeing the defense.
Found the tight corner, put it down. 22-20. Back to serve now. Reagan Holler. Exploded on by Abby Wackle.
Well, and you got to give a lot of credit there also to Molly Martin. She held the middle by coming in that quick transition, holds the middle, gives Wackle a one-on-one matchup. So great team effort. And great decision by the setter to make that choice.
Into the block. Good up there by Connor. There's Waco again, right at Connor. What a swing by Abby Waco. She now has 29 kills, and we are even at 22.
I think she left a mark on that one. She definitely got her attention. I believe that was Connor that took that. Wow.
We're going away from the set, swinging back at it, Keck, with the kill.
She didn't have a lot of room to get that between the antenna. And like you said, her body.
Cruzy with the serve. Bump set to Waco, push. Kept it alive. Oh, nice play. How about Connor? Found the
Yep.
Donut right in the middle and put the Stars here at set point. Trying to send it to a fifth here in the C1 title game. Uzi again. Good up by Linebach. Wackle got the kill. That is an even 30. 30 kills for Abby Wackle.
On 64 swings. 65, excuse me. An arm. You being going to be hanging low tomorrow.
Block. Knotted at 24. We've got extra points here in set number four. Must win set for Kearney Catholic. Warriors need this for the title.
Kind of a free ball here.
DeWackle. Wow. Abby Wackle with 31, and the Warriors have match point here at the Devaney Center. 37-2 record on the year. Looking for their second title in 3 years. Free ball over, opportunity here for the Warriors. Wackle for the win. Got it! Abby Wackle, 32 kills, Lincoln Lutheran state champs. Second time in 3 years, Lincoln Lutheran takes home the title in Class C1. They won it in 2019, and they win it again in 2021. And who else would close it out other than Abby Wackle? The swing, the return is long, and the celebration ensues. Medals and trophies when we come back.
Farming is more than just work. It's your way of life. Protecting your family's legacy is our way of life. Through challenges and successes, we understand your family's insurance needs. With every turn of the wheel, for every investment, through every season, generation after generation, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, always alongside you.
Sports fans, seasons change with new teams, new players, and new excitement. Just minutes from state championship venues, Sarpy County has year-round family fun, shopping, restaurants, and more than 2,000 hotel rooms. Your visitor's guide from GoSarpy.com helps start new traditions when you, family, and friends visit Eastern Nebraska. GoSarpy.com. So near, so fun.
Sometimes you just have to be a little stronger, go a little farther, be a little tougher. This past year was a test to see if we could step up and weather the storm together. We are committed to push a little harder, go a little farther, lean into the challenge, and be tougher together. Aurora and you.
Coverage of the 2021 NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Celebration for the new champs, Lincoln Lutheran. They win in four, 26 to 24. Time now to hand out medals and trophies, and for that we go to Steve Lemon.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, the Nebraska Coaches Association, and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support positive sportsmanship during the state championships and throughout the season. At this time, we are pleased to present the Sportsmanship Award for Class C1. The trophy is graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. The sportsmanship program is exclusively presented by Concordia University of Nebraska, now proudly partnering with Concordia University Irvine, California, in offering the nation's number one graduate program in coaching and athletics administration and exercise sciences. Making the presentation is Nebraska Coaches Association Executive Director Darren Boyson. The Class C1 Sportsmanship Award winner is Columbus Lakeview High School. Congratulations, Columbus Lakeview High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is honored to have medals and trophies for both of these outstanding teams. Presentations will be made by NSAA Executive Director Jay Beller, NSAA Board of Directors Kathy Wieskamp from Lincoln Public Schools, and Ryan Rule of Centura. Also, U.S. Bank Representative Teresa McClatchy. Here are the awards for runner-up Kearney Catholic High School. Head coach Chris Connor and her assistants will present the silver medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number one, Lauren Canteris. Number two, Margaret Harburg. Number four, Jenna Cruzy. Number five, Sophie Connor. Number seven, Claire Rogers. Number nine, Avery Mandernack. Number 11, Lindsay Vanderbeek. Number 12, Malia Johnson. Number 14, Peyton Dezingle. Number 18, Callie Squires. Number 19, London Carnes. And now the seniors, number three, Ashley Keck. Number six, Josie Denny. And number 15, Sydney Connor. And now for these outstanding athletes in their school, here is the 2021 NSAA Class C1 State Volleyball Runner-Up Trophy. Congratulations, Kearney Catholic High School. And now to the champions, Lincoln Lutheran High School. Head coach Sue Ziegler, we have a special award for you. And now Coach Ziegler and her assistants will present the gold medals. Please, players, please come forward as your name is called. Number one, Carrie Limebach. Number three, Alicia Sadoff. Number eight, Jordan Ernstmeyer. Number nine, Addison Blahovitz. Number 10, Sophie Wolgamuth. Number 13, Erica Young. Number 24, Abby Wuckel. And now the seniors, number seven, Reagan Holly. Number two, Reagan Holly. Number four, Lily Pensick. Number five, Adriana Rodenzel. Number seven, Ashlyn DeBoer. Number 11, Molly Martin. Number 16, Caitlin Oxley. And number 20, Shanae Burt. Presenting the championship game ball from Farmers Mutual Insurance, District Manager Dan Chambers. And now for these outstanding athletes and their school, here is the 2021 NSAA Class C1 State Volleyball Championship Trophy. Congratulations, Lincoln Lutheran High School.
Well, for the second time in 3 years, Lincoln Lutheran takes home a state championship trophy. They made it to the finals in 2018, 19, and here in 2021. And who else would close it out but Abby Waffle? What a match. We'll hear from them when we come back.
Have you heard about FAFSA?
It's like a form you fill out.
Fill it out and you get money for college.
Easiest way to get money for college, hands down.
FAFSA.
It's a life hack.
It's your way in.
So you want to help me pay for college? I'm down.
Heck yeah.
Definitely.
How is this not trending on all the things?
It took me like 30 minutes to fill out.
So easy.
How much am I gonna get?
This is a hidden gem. Fill out your FAFSA.
FAFSA.
Drink water, buckle up, fill out your FAFSA.
This is a growing corn plant. It's not battery powered. It doesn't have a 300-mile range, but it's vital in our fight against climate change. Reducing 46% of carbon emissions and producing clean burning ethanol. Corn ethanol is the climate solution we need now.
Constellation is a natural gas supplier helping inspire young Nebraskans through hands-on learning. Constellation has given more than $290,000 to 4-H and FFA organizations across the state, helping support youth in your community with opportunities to achieve real-world success. Because we believe that powering communities means empowering our future leaders. With Constellation, a contribution to 4-H and FFA is in the stars.
Participating in multiple Nebraska high school activities has taught me the value of teamwork.
I learned how to be a strong leader among my peers.
We set goals as a team and work hard to accomplish them.
I strive to excel not only in the classroom, but on the playing field.
The Nebraska School Activities Association providing opportunities in 25 activities for our member high schools. NSAA Activities, the other half of education.
Coverage of the 2021 NSAA Volleyball Championships is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Education Quest Foundation, Nebraska Public Power District, Nebraska Kubota Dealers, Nebraska Corn Board, Aurora Cooperative, and Constellation. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support.
Back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center, Lincoln Lutheran state champs for the second time in 3 years. I'm joined with head coach Sue Ziegler. And coach, that was a heck of a match.
That was so fun.
Very competitive. And take me through what you thought was the difference.
You know, I think we had a couple of the hitters right here, Abby and Caitlin, that really stepped up. They were hitting positive, and we told the team that we needed to get a good ball up to the setters, and they need to feed them the ball, and they just took over. So I'm just so proud of what they did to finish things out.
Kearney Catholic, I mean, those have been some battles recently between you guys last year at the state tournament and then at the conference tournament this year. Can you just talk a little bit about how well Kearney Catholic played as well?
Yeah, I mean, they're the only team this year that's taken a set away from us in Class C1 in the conference tournament. And then now, and we were kind of in the same position where in one of the sets we were down a little bit, and in that last set was able to persevere and come back. And so we're very thankful for the win and give God all the glory for that.
You have such a well-balanced team, too, up and down. I mean, there seems to be no holes defensively. You said you have, well, you think two of the best defenders in the state, then obviously some power at the net. So how do you, you know, put together such a well-balanced team, and can this continue into future years?
You know, these girls work for it. It's not just given to them. But, yeah, Reagan and Carrie in the back row, between those two, it's really hard to find a spot to, and I'll put the ball down. But we have other girls that step in, too. But we do a lot of great balls out of system. And when we get those kills, we get pretty excited about that, too. So all of our girls have a lot of, you know, talent and skills. So that's why it's been so fun to coach this team, because of the diversity.
And what's this mean to you to be holding that trophy again?
It feels great. I love it. But again, it's for them. It's not my trophy. It's the team's trophy. It's the school's trophy. It's everybody that supported us. We have great families, great fans, great, you know, administration that's going to, you know, stand behind us all the way. They were there cheering for us. And, you know, these girls are very deserving of it. But we're thankful for the community of Lincoln Lutheran, too.
Absolutely. Congratulations, coach.
Thank you. Thanks.
All right, let's bring in Caitlin Oxley. Caitlin finished with 12 kills, hit 391. Very impressive overall game for you. And how does this feel to be holding that trophy?
It's amazing. I never expected myself coming in freshman year to be a state championship, but it's amazing. I love this team, and it's just a great experience.
Now, the sets that you guys won, 25-23, 25-23, 26-24, so very competitive, razor-thin margin of error. What do you think was the difference?
I just know our team knows we can win it, and we just pushed through. We had great determination. We have a great bench as well, and we are just determined to win.
So I want to ask you about Abby, because she put on a show, 32 kills, and had a big one at the end, too. Mm-hmm. What'd you think about her performance?
I mean, Abby's an amazing player, and I just can't wait to see what she does next year and in college. Mm-hmm.
And you as well, going to DePaul, so best of luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, congratulations, Caitlin. All right, let's bring in Abby. 32 kills, as I mentioned, hit 353, added 14 digs. How's it feel to be holding that?
I can't describe it. It's amazing.
That last kill, I mean, you had some impressive kills, but the last one, I feel like you had a little extra on that one, didn't you?
Definitely. I just wanted to put it away and take home the trophy.
And you had, you know, across the net, another big hitter in Ashley Keck as well. How fun is it going against a team like Kearney Catholic, against another big hitter like Keck?
It's great. It brings out all the competitiveness of the team, and everyone just pushes to get that much better and pushes to get the next point.
And Lincoln Lutheran, you guys have something really special building. 5 consecutive appearances in the state tournament. Lost in the semis last year, but state champs in 2019 and state champs here again. Where do you think this program's heading?
I think we're going to stay every single year with this great coach and these great players and everything that she produces. The effort that goes into it, we'll be here again.
Congratulations, Abby.
Thank you.
Lincoln Lutheran state champs for the second time in 3 years. They win and thrilling 4 sets over Kearney Catholic.
Thank you very much, Ryan. That closes out the Class C1 title. And once again, Lincoln Lutheran wins it for the second time in 3 years, 26-24 in set number 4. You see the teams getting ready to compete in the Class B state championship warming up. And when you think about dynasties in Nebraska high school volleyball, several programs come to mind, but there are only three who have won six consecutive state championships. Shickley from 87 to 92, Bellevue West did it from 92 to 97, and Omaha Scott, led by Renee Sanders, who is looking to make history tonight with a seventh state title in a row.
I was so excited to be a part of a program that just has so much culture, and they prepare you for challenges in life.
We always talk at the beginning of the year how it's a journey, and I don't think any journey has been the same. They've had their ups, they've had their downs, they've had their things we need to figure out. But those journeys that you go through with those kids and like all those experiences, they just make it unforgettable, but also very independent of each other. It's not like we just won six. Every single one had a story behind it, and every single one of them was memorable.
We've grown a lot together. I appreciate her, I respect her, I trust her in everything that we do, even if a drill, if we're not getting it, I trust her, and I know that she's not making this up just for fun, like it's gonna help us in the long run.
You have to evolve with the game, but you have to evolve with the kids. How I run my practices has changed, how we train has changed. Things that we do outside of the gym have changed. You know, the team bonding, the program building, you know, all the little details that go into running a program, I think have evolved and changed over my last 10 years. I mean, I do things a lot different than I did when I got here.
I think that's why we come into the gym every day with an open mind, and why we work so hard and do different things, because no one wants us to win. I mean, we're SCUT, so I think we accept that challenge, and I think we like it. It drives us. We like the challenge.
Housie for the kill in the championship. Six in a row for Scott.
You know, you could have the most talented team and not win. You know, you could have the best coach in the state and not win. You know, but when you manage to put all the pieces together and work together, those dynasty teams have all found ways where the coaches and the players are all working towards a common goal.
Like, let's celebrate everything, right? Because we can't take anything for granted.
I think that's one of the things we're gonna focus on this year is appreciating every day. Obviously, every day it's hard to come into the gym every single day with a bunch of energy, but I think if we think about appreciating it, it will work out in the end.
That dog pile that like you get at the very end, when all of the practices, early mornings, everything becomes worth it, it's like you feel it through your whole body. It's so cool.
As a coach, that's my hope, is that every single year I put out a great product that competes and plays hard. And if it bounces our way and we win, awesome. But if not, we're gonna hang our hat that we did everything we could. Just having the opportunity to win one. That's all we wanna do, is win one championship. It wasn't ever like at one that we were gonna win seven or that we were gonna win five. No, like we're just trying to win one. And that's the goal.
Okay.
So there it is. Scott, Bellevue West, Shickley have won six in a row. An opportunity for Renee Saunders and her Scott Catholic team to be the first in Nebraska high school history to win seven in a row. And wouldn't it be apropos that it would come in the 50th anniversary year of these NSAA state championships? Take a look at the schedule. What's happened so far today in D2 this morning? It was our only five setter, and that was Sacred Heart over St. Francis. Then Howells Dodge and Oakland Craig won back-to-back. Lumped them together because they both won first ever state championships. Then moments ago, Lincoln Lutheran closed out their second title in 3 years. Coming up, we've got Scott and Norris, and we close it out tonight with Millard West and Papillion La Vista South. That's the schedule of the 2021 NSAA championships. Don't forget, coming up, we've got the Class B title on the way, but once again, Lincoln Lutheran wins the state title in C1. For Kathy Wieskamp and our entire sports production crew, I'm Larry Putney. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll be back here in just a moment with the Class B title game.